leaving the middle. If you let yourself get tangled, you're going to make a wonderful grown-up.
Ms. Cochran.
Oh, yes, Mr. Flint.
How much or how often do these students practice?
Well, how often do you guys practice?
So auditions for this group interpretation begins about a little bit before winter break, and then right afterwards we get cast, and we kind of start working right away. We rehearse 4 days a week, typically, from either 3 to 5:30 or 6 to 9 on a couple of those later days, because Robbie and Bo have children. We're shared amongst other groups and stuff like that, so we typically meet 4 days a week until it gets down to crunch time, like this week before sectionals, and then we kind of meet a little bit longer, kind of extended hours for everyone.
They're super involved, many of them, all of them. How many of you are in other extracurriculars? Okay, how many of you are involved in a sport during the year? Okay, so quite a bit. How many of you are in musical? Okay, so we share them with some other lucky activities and sports in groups, so we try to make it work. Can you watch it again? That's what we hope the judges say.
Tomorrow at 12:30 noonish. At Richards, come see it. Come support us. It'll be our sectional, so that's the last one we can do until we get to state.
How many of you guys are in the two Robinson, and myself, we, as you can imagine, ignore us. We are big readers. We love watching things. And so we are always looking for something that strikes us. And we can kind of start, if we're reading or watching, we can kind of picture, students doing things, making those pictures they make, or something go on to stage. So let's say you came in third and you were 1 second over, you would be fourth and you would have a very sad bus ride home. Luckily, I know what, it never happened to us where we've been over at sectionals. And so hopefully you'll never have to find that out. Good question, Mr. Gary. Yeah.
Wow, what's the different significance between like handing something like actually looking at the other actor or just handing it to the crowd?
Yeah.
A lot of times when it's like two actors actually looking at each other, that means they have like a connection, like a strong connection than like cross-focus looking. So like when you see it, like the aviator and the girl always like most of the time look at each other because they have a bigger connection than like my character and Little Prince.
It kind of also works out that way so that if you're not always looking at each other, the judges and some criteria that we're critiqued on is that how well we're engaged in the story, and the judges want to see everything that we can give them. So sometimes when I'm talking to you guys or Melissa's talking to Anthony and they're talking out more openly, it's so that people can see us so we're not always closed off.